Hi, I'm David Wild, and I'm very happy to be here with Barry Manilow, as if I had to tell you that yet again. And when I first was listening to this album, I was, by this point, I'm already blown away, but I see a title called Trainwreck, and I can already hear this edgy, discordant sort of statement of how messed up things are and someone falling apart. And instead, I get probably one of the most beautiful melodies and something, it's a stunning song, a heartfelt, sympathetic. Throughout this album, there's always a lot of heart in your work, and you're not seeing these people, like the way the press writes about train wrecks, it's they think the worst possible thing about
you
them.
No, you're so right.
No, but you're trying
no,
to view this
I mean,
character
the
from the
that
best
you
possible
were expecting,
way. Yes.
I should have written something edgy.
No. There's enough edge. For you, there's a whole lot of edge on this record. But tell me about Trainwreck.
Well, we got the title when they were driving Britney Spears crazy. Now, this was one of the first ones we wrote. We got the whole idea when we were watching them in horror, all of us were watching the press, the paparazzi drive Britney Spears crazy, this beautiful, young, talented girl just wanting to go to Starbucks or her rehearsal, and they just wouldn't leave her alone. And Nick and I, my collaborator, Nick Anderson, and I said, is this the price of fame these days? You can't go to Starbucks without them surrounding you? It's awful. And they started to call her a train wreck because I think they actually drove her crazy. And she did start to do some really wild things, and they started to call it Trainwreck. And Nick wrote a lyric called Trainwreck. And we put it at the end of the album, which is about somebody who wants fame, gets it, blows it, and tries to start again. And so the reason that I didn't write an edgy thing for Trainwreck is because I imagined this person alone in a hotel room, finally realizing that he blew it, and he has to pull himself together. And that's why it is more reflective and introspective than edgy.
It's a beautiful song. Can we share a little with the nice people?
Look in the mirror. Could it be clearer? End of the line. Way off the rails, next door to nowhere. Lamp burning low where the sun used to shine. Beautiful words.
Wake up, train wreck.
One thing that strikes me about this album and this song is, and even seeing you last night in your show, you have more perspective to share with people than any time in your life. Like, I think that's the best show. I've seen you many times over decades. That's the best show I've ever seen because you really put yourself into it and share with people your point of view. And for this album, people have written about fame before. There's a good song by Bowie called Fame. Mm-hmm. But I think you really are sharing what you've learned along the way.
Well, you know, here's the chorus.
Maybe I played too hard. Maybe I ran too fast. Maybe I was their hero. That don't last. Flame out, train wreck. Hey, what's past is past.
You know, I think because I've lived all this, that I could write this album and it rings of truth. Because I didn't mean to write an autobiographical album. I really didn't mean to it. I really was writing a fictitious story about somebody who wanted fame. But as we began to get into the writing of it, and I didn't even spot it then, but when I started to do the vocals on the album, I realized that I had lived through all of it. And I wasn't writing about myself, but the only way I could do it as an actor was to dig up memories of each song. And damn, I had gone through every single song. And this, I mean, I don't think I've ever been down that far, but I had to pull myself together a couple of times over these last 35 years. I mean, I got pretty well down, you know, with records that didn't make it and audiences that didn't come. And you feel like you're dying. You feel like it's over. And you have to pull yourself together and say, no, I've still got it. I've still got something here. And maybe I wasn't a train wreck, but I did have to say, okay, now what?
Get back on the right track,
right,
at least.
Right. So anyway, I do think it's an interesting song, and it's an interesting way to end this album too, because he starts to I wanted the music to say he was pulling himself together. I quote Bring On Tomorrow here, you know. And then he goes back into 15 minutes, which says, come on.
Right, there's that echo of right. hope again.
Like he says, can't call it a life. I'm gonna...
Hanging at home with a scrapbook. They say I'm over the hill. A loser at 23. Everything's gonna be alright. Look at that spotlight waiting for me.
And then he goes into it again.
No, this is not the final story.
And who knows, man? Who knows if this guy's gonna do it again? But I hope he does. I hope he does. Anyway, thanks. Give it a shot. Give it a shot. I love it. I hope you do too.
Give it at least 15 minutes.
Thanks, David.